Greetings, true believers. This is DM Gashbad, bringing you a special scenario for the Marvel Universe Miniatures game. That dastardly race of shape-shifting aliens, the Skrulls, have invaded Earth yet again. Mr. Fantastic has gone missing, but before his disappearance, he sent out a message to all the heroes and villains of our planet. He has built an amazing machine that can detect the Skrulls. It is disguised as an old helicopter landing pad. But before it can be activated, it needs to be keyed by scanning non-Skrull DNA. So, defenders of Earth, move to the helipad. Stay until the scan is complete and keep everyone else off. You never know who could secretly be a Skrull. Excelsior!
Hello everyone, this is a special scenario I developed to teach people the rules of the Marvel Universe Miniatures game. It's designed to have a lot of people play at once and to slowly go through the rules and abilities as you go along. It's based loosely on the WWE pay-per-view event, the Royal Rumble, so if there are any wrestling fans, I hope that you can see the inspiration for this. Anyway, let's get right down to the setup. The first thing that you need is a table like this, with an area in the middle. It doesn't have to be anything in particular. I'm using this helipad, but it can easily be just about a 12-inch diameter circle, a small building. Anything that distinguishes it from the rest of the terrain is accessible to all the characters and is in the exact center. The rest of the terrain you can throw in however you like and with whatever you have, but this is how I've laid out my board. The next thing to do is take your Marvel Universe Miniatures Games cards. How many cards you use will depend on how many models you have painted and available, and how long you want the game to last. Now, if you want to be traditional and follow the rules of the WWE Royal Rumble, you'll use about 30. I think it's a good idea to use as many as you have. Now, what I like to do is I like to take the most powerful cards, basically anything with a level over 10. So we'll take out Thor, Incredible Hulk, and Sentry here, and we'll set them aside for a moment. The rest we'll just turn face down and we'll shuffle them up. Oops. So, as I said, if you're like me, you've taken your updated cards from the website and you've printed out your own. You're not using the cards that actually came with the models, because a lot of them have been outdated and some of them are just unavailable now anyway. So, shuffle them up. Then take the most powerful ones, shuffle those up, cut the deck, put those about halfway through. Now the reason you want to do that is because they're going to come in at intervals, and just like in the Royal Rumble, you don't want the Undertaker to show up in the very last spot. He'll probably just win. And it also helps to make sure that the same player doesn't get all the most powerful characters. As I said before, if you don't have printed versions, if you just have the cards, that's fine. What I recommend doing is, again, taking out the most powerful ones, taking all the rest, there you go, and putting them in a bag or bowl, hat, helmet, some other opaque container, one in one bag, one in the other. And when it comes time to draw a card, simply reach in. And then sometime in the middle of the match, everyone starts drawing from the more powerful ones. The next thing to do is gather up a bunch of different colored dice or counters or chips or anything like that. I've chosen dice here. You want a different color for each player that's participating. So here you see I've presupposed we've got four players, and so I've got four sets of colored dice. I'm using eight. If you're playing a 30 model match, that sounds about right. So first thing, we're just going to take one of each color and put them in a good opaque container like this bag. Now it's time to start playing. So have someone reach in to the bag of mystery, pull out colored die. Whoever's die that is, they get the first turn. So what you do on your first turn is you then go to the stack of nicely shuffled character cards, and you draw the top one. In this case, we get Toad. We get Mortimer Toynbee. Okay, good news, bad news. So, player who drew Toad gets to choose a side to come in on. If you got four players, just choose the center of each side of the board. If you have more than four, you might have to start using the corners. You'll figure it out. Anyway, let's say our player has got their toad. This is an opportunity, if they haven't played the game before, to show them how they get their power, how to set up their health, all that kind of thing. And they deploy their model right in the middle on that side of the board. Now you get to show them how to move. So for simplicity's sake, I'm just going to say Mortimer here is going to super jump right up on top of the helipad, which is where he wants to be anyway. And then he's going to end his turn. So now here's how you score points in this scenario. Every time you end a turn with one of your models on top of the helipad, you score 1 point for each model. So let's say Steve here just finished his turn and he has Toad on top of the helipad. Well, that fabulous device scans Toad's DNA, be it Skrull or human, or mutant in this case, and so Steve gets 1 point. Now then, you go to the bag, draw a new die. That player chooses their first card. In this case, we get Deadpool, Mr. Wade Wilson, and we'll set him up immediately clockwise in the next section. So let's grab our Deadpool model. Exactly as before, he gets his turn. Let's say he body slides onto the helipad to say hello to Toad. He goes through his activations. He probably chops up Toad a little bit. Then, of course, the way the game works is you cycle around, and so the next player gets their activation, and so Toad will have an opportunity to go, and then we go on to the next turn. And the next turn, we draw a third die. That player then chooses their starting character. In this case, we have Rogue. Rogue comes on the board, takes the next clockwise slot. She gets her turn. Right there. And so she flies up. Then she gets to decide whether the play proceeds counterclockwise, so Deadpool would go and then Toad, or clockwise, in which case it would be Toad, then Deadpool. After everyone has accomplished all their activations, we then get the final draw. We get the final die. The last player draws their card, Nova. He takes the remaining spot. And he gets his turn. Goes through all his powers and abilities that he wants to use. He decides whether play proceeds counterclockwise or clockwise. And then that's it for the initial first turns for all the players. And of course, at the end of every turn, you count up how many characters are on the helipad. So assuming Deadpool hasn't, for whatever reason, sliced Toad to ribbons, at the end of those first four turns, Steve would have 4 points for his Toad hanging out at the on the helipad for each of those turns. Bruce would have 3 points because Deadpool is up there for three turns. And Natasha and Tony have yet to get on the board. After those initial turns, the next thing to do is to take all the dice, including the four that we used originally, put them into the bag of mystery. Draw a die. Whoever's die that is gets to go first. They determine whether the play then proceeds counterclockwise or clockwise. The only exception is that when it comes to Steve's turn, Steve will draw a new character card. In this case, it's Lady Mastermind. So, when it comes to Steve's turn, he can either activate Toad and go through all his actions, or he can deploy Lady Mastermind and go with all her actions. And once everyone has completed all their actions for all the models currently on the table, Steve will get whoever he didn't decide to use first. So if he decides to move Toad first, everyone will take their actions, and then Lady Mastermind will come on the table and do her actions. If he decides to deploy Lady Mastermind first, Lady Mastermind will get to go. Everyone, assuming everyone finishes their actions, then Toad will get to go. From then on, everyone will take their turn as normal. The only difference is that on each person's turn, they get to choose one character to activate. And then after everyone has gotten to choose one character, then people with more than one model on the board get to activate their second character. And of course, when it's your turn to get a new character, for example, Steve went last and Lady Mastermind came on, so then the next person to go would be Bruce. So when it's Bruce's turn, he can either activate Deadpool or he can deploy and activate Drax the Destroyer. So there you have it. It proceeds that way. You go clockwise to determine who gets to bring on a new character. You draw a die to determine who goes first in the turn. And as is normal for the Marvel Universe miniatures game, each player chooses one model to activate, and then everyone else gets to activate a model. And then when it comes around again, a player has the option of activating yet another model, and so on and so forth. Now, certain skills can affect some of this. Obviously, if you have Tactician, you can make more than one model go one after the other. If you have, for example, Emma Frost, and she has Mastermind, Mastermind says you take one of your dies, and you add it to the bag, and remove one of your opponent's dice. So you just randomly choose the green die, so we add one of Emma's dice, and lose a random person's die. Other than that, play should proceed exactly the same. One thing to keep in mind, this is obviously not meant to be a serious tournament-style scenario. This is supposed to be a fun introduction to the game, giving people an idea of the rules, and familiarizing them with a lot of the different characters in the game. So, if someone can only play for a certain amount of time, if you're running an event and someone has to leave, just go into the random bag, pull out all their colored dice, put the rest back in, and continue playing. Likewise, if someone stops by and says, "Hey, what's this game? Can I try?" Say absolutely, grab them a new set of dice, a new color, put those in the bag, give them a corner to deploy in, and let them join in. At the very end of the game, the last model left on the helipad gets an additional 5 points. So here we have Steve. He'll get an additional 5 points. The game ends, and you count up all the points, and whoever has the most is the winner. There you have it. That's the scenario. Hope it works for you. Let me know what you think, or if you have any questions, and certainly if you try it out, let me know how it goes. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.